Shalom, family. This is your brother Dana coming to you from Chicago, from a place in one love. As I've mentioned before, these videos are just for me to be able to share my heart with you. Many of you may know that about the second week of October, I came down with COVID and I was in bed until about the second week of November. And during that period of time, the Most High made it very clear to me that my time here in Chicago after 28 years was coming to an end. And so I've put my house on the market and under contract right now to move to Atlanta, to trust the Most High Yah that He will meet me there and that He will keep His promise to allow me to fulfill my passion and my desire, and that is to serve Him, to glorify Him, and to love Him, the Lord my God, the Most High Yah, with all my heart and soul, and to love you, my neighbor, and to serve you, specifically my chosen family members of the Most High Yah, with all that I can. And so as I'm closing up and kind of getting ready for this new chapter of my life, this new chapter also without my father, I ran across this video, and I want to share it with you. This video is probably from about 2005, when One Love was called Studio 2911, and in this video, you will see my dream of what Studio 2911 was going to be. But that dream was cut down when the city of Chicago determined to tear down the property that I owned and now come after me these years later still for the cost of them tearing down my property. And I'll never forget that day. I fell to my knees out on that street after I was called by those out on it saying, "Pastor, Pastor, they're tearing down our property." And I felt just that hopelessness of that death of that dream. Well, I've continued to fight and do whatever I can do to empower the people the Most High Yah has placed before me. But as I said, I'm closing up the doors to my chapter of life here in Chicago. And I came across this video. And I just wanted to share it with you. Because most of you, if not all of you, have only gotten to know me and feel my heart and hopefully test my spirit over these last 5 years or so since I've been before you on YouTube and social media. But my journey with the Most High Yah began way before you saw me here on YouTube. And I hope and I pray that this video will give you just a little bit more of a history of me and how the Most High Yah has had His hand so faithfully on my life and why I am so grateful and honored not only to serve Him, but to know the truth of who you are and to serve you. So I hope you enjoy this, but this was one of my visions when One Love was Studio 2911. And who knows, family, maybe Chicago wasn't the place for the Most High Yah to bless, because maybe it's supposed to be Atlanta. So I hope you enjoy this, and we'll see you on the other side. Shalom, family.
If you gotta start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world missions, love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night.
If you gotta start sometime. Hi, my name is Dana, aka Rebbe D. I'm living over on the west side of Chicago in a community called North Lawnville. Been here for about 8 years. I'm here because I have a desire and my passion is to build a youth center by the name of Studio 2911 The Place. This vision came about almost 16 years ago. It happened after I had an incident with several guys that represented a gang, and instead of greeting me as they walked by, they kind of beat me up. And I had a choice to make, like we all do. I had a choice to either live a life to go against individuals like that, or to live a life to empower individuals that I feel low self-esteem, they're down and out, they don't have a purpose, they don't have a reason. To empower at-risk youth and even young adults to be instilled with hope, to have a purpose, to have a reason to live. We gotta reach people mind, body, and soul. And Studio 2911, I believe, is gonna be a place like that. That's why it's The Place.
24 Ward, I used heroin and cocaine for almost 20 years. I've been saved and sanctified, and God delivered me for 10, and is you rolling?
Yeah. I'm getting it all.
You ain't rolling for that. I have 4 children, they are teenagers, and I have 2 adult children that I'm active in their life.
What do you see as somebody that lives in the neighborhood here, has kids? What's your fear? What's, you think, one of the obstacles and fears for your kids living in the North Lawndale community here?
That, you know, sometimes being a single parent, you yourself can't be the role model for your children, and they need to look forward. And I have 2 boys, and you know, you can raise a boy, but you can't teach him how to be a man. So my biggest fear for any child is that they might go down the same path that I chose to go down, which was the drugs and, you know, just trying to fit in, you know, with the inner crowd, which is not always the good crowd.
You know, how do we stir up gifts in young people? That you know, I ask a lot of the guys out on the street and young ladies, you know, what do you want to do with your life? They don't even have the dreams. And if some of them have dreams, they don't think they're even going to get there because of all the issues and stuff that they're facing on a daily basis.
So we're on 16th Street right now.
Yes, we're on 16th.
And what's the reputation of 16th Street?
Oh, 16th Street. Oh, you hear about 16th Street in New York City. 16th Street is known for heroin and cocaine use, just drugs and violent crimes and drive-bys and just a real high crime rate.
My name is Troy Ali, and I'm a member of the Lawndale community.
What would you say, if it's not for yourself, at least for a lot of the people around you, a lot of the young people around you, are some of the obstacles or some of the issues that most of the young folk face in being successful or just living a good life?
I would have to say peer pressure, because that's the main thing. It seems as if, like, the youth these days, they try to do it like they try to please their friends, like, you know, like, they feel as though, like, their friends think that it's cool because they sell drugs, and they're going to try to sell drugs. Or, you know, it, like, the main thing is about, all about, you know, having some money in your pocket. And, you know, if you can't get a job, then the first thing you're going to go to is the streets to, you know, help you, help to put money in your pocket. So I think that's the main problem that's out here.
Today's first question is, what is it like being, what's y'all age?
21 and 22. 22. Y'all live in, how far y'all live from?
We live everywhere, over around here.
Okay.
Pretty much.
What is it like living in this area?
See, it depends on who you is. Okay. If you ain't from this area, you live here, probably be kind of crazy to you, but hey, you been there, you whatever.
It's
whatever. Same old, same old.
Yeah. My name's Mary Wiley. And when Dana talked about his vision, I was like, oh my God, we could help each other. And I said so many times, I see a lot of the kids on the corners and they don't have anything to do. Initially, I thought, well, they're there because they want to be there. That's not really true. That they need some help, they need to be mentored, they need to have hope. A lot of times, just someone with an encouraging word someone that cares, someone that loves them.
What do you need confidence in or courage in?
Okay, courage in to walk out of my house to go to school. When I walk, usually around this time of night or even early in the morning, because I walk out the door to go to school at about 7:05. And it's a lot of drug dealers smoking sitting on my front porch outside the area of my front gate. Just encourage to walk out the front, walk out the door, because I might, it's kids outside that my age selling drugs. I see them.
2911. Based on Jeremiah 29:11.
All right.
You know, we can give people careers, we can give them employment, we can give them education, but if they don't have hope, eventually if they don't get the job they were hoping for, you know, a lot of guys get out of jail, they have all the desire and in the zeal to do what's right.
Yes.
But then what happens when they go to job after job after job after job and they look at that little mark on their resume?
Yes.
They've got to have hope.
Yes.
To sustain them through the difficult times. So Studio 2911 is the place.
Okay.
Place of refuge, place of hope, place of encouragement, place of empowerment. Every person that walks in way needs something different.
Okay.
My name is Tremaine Weaver, also known as TDUB, that's T-Dub. A vision that's being manifested in 2911 is needed because look at the daily news, you know what I mean? Look at our young people dying. Not fulfilling their purpose, you know, the senseless acts of violence and crime. The youth need something to do. If it's a recording studio, a basketball gym, the arts, bringing the arts back to the community. Studio 2911 is so needed. That's why we have to bring this thing to pass. Not, you know, we're going to try, we have to bring it to pass.
I believe we need to stir up the gift in young people. And music is an absolute kind of a drawing. It's effective in every culture. And so with some recording studios, we can lure the kids in, and as they come in, we can build up in them self-esteem and a purpose through music, helping them write music. Helping them write music that doesn't put people down, but is more inspirational, encouraging, something that speaks life into people instead of death. The other element of Studio 2911 that goes hand in hand with the recording studio is the Performing Arts Center. But most of the stages that I see the young people on are a stage that is in front of a judge where they're being sentenced to some time because of a crime. Or the ultimate stage, which is in a casket being buried. And I think it's about time that we have a stage where the young people can display a talent. You know, I want to have a barbershop. Twofold. The neighborhood needs a barbershop. So people come in, they get their hair cut. The music, the atmosphere is different. It's uplifting, it's encouraging, it's inviting, it makes them want to come back. But then the guys that are cutting the hair are guys that we're empowering that are maybe coming out of the correctional facility. Maybe have a felony on their record that's keeping them from getting a job. So we're not looking at what they've done. We believe in where they can go. It's very important for multi-culture and generation of people to come together. So we want to have a coffee shop that'll do just that, where we've got the older people in the neighborhood, those full of wisdom, those that have experienced a whole lot of things, to be able to get together with the younger generation and have some cross-pollination happen in there. Have some food that is more on that healthy note. So I want Studio 2911, whether it's through the barbershop, whether it's through the school, whether it's through the after school program that we want to have, whether it's through the mentoring program, whether it's through the recording studios or the Performing Arts Center, or even the gym that we're going to have, I want it to be a place where young people, young adults, senior citizens, when they come in, they will not walk out the same way they came. That they will have somebody there that's going to speak a word of encouragement to them. Somebody there is going to care about what they need. Somebody there is going to help them gain a skill, maybe that will help them not just get a job, but get a career.
And I'm a homeless man. When I met him, I was on the edge of death. When I met him, I was on my way to jump off the Eisenhower Expressway. You know what I'm saying? I gave up on life. You know what I'm saying? But when I met these people, I got some hope. I seen some. I seen God. I seen more than most people see around here in this community. I seen something that would make this community shine. And that's what I'm golden for. And if God give me the strength to live, I want to see that. I want to see a church. I want to see a shelter. I want to see the studio here. I want to see something that's going to bring something to this community.
And I just know it's a great community. And by Studio 2911 being built, it's going to be a better community. It's going to be 10 times better because you're going to have more angels around here, you know, to make sure that we really have protection. The police going to do so much, but the angels are 10 times better than the police officers. So
the exciting thing about all this is that we actually own property. We own property at 3650 West 16th Street. The building there now is coming down. The exciting thing is that we've got the drawings for the new building. The thing that we need is I can't make this on my own. I need people like yourselves to partner with me. I need people like you that will run with this vision with me. We need people with resources. We need people that have a passion for North Lawndale. We need people that have a desire to empower, that can be a life coach, that can help train, that can even be a mentor, that can walk alongside some of the young men and women that we're bringing in. Studio 2911 is based on a verse that says, I believe in that God has a purpose, plan, and a reason for our lives. And so if you're still breathing, I believe your purpose is not yet over. And it's time that we have a place where the atmosphere is there to speak life and not death, to speak blessings and not curses, to empower and not to destroy, to uplift and not to, you know, push down. And that's Studio 2911.
This could be your finest hour. All you have to do is step up. What will you do?
If you gotta start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world missions, love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints to wait. Start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now?